Now we'll see an enzymatic reaction. Suppose a reaction is going on in the presence of an enzyme. So enzyme binds to substrate forming an enzyme substrate complex, which is converted to enzyme product complex, and then it dissociates from the enzyme to form the free enzyme and the product. So here, how should we define a transition state? So these are very important questions we need to answer. What is a transition state? So the transition state is the highest energy space is created during the conversion of substrate to product. So when the enzyme is not present, so this S superscript double dagger, okay, so this is a double dagger symbol. Is the highest energy species, but in the presence of enzyme, the energy of this highest energy species decreases to a lower level. So now this is indicated as S activated, which is in complex with the enzyme. So the transition state here is not a stable species; it is highly short-lived, but it can't be purified or it cannot be imaged as such, because it is a fleeting species which is created during the conversion of substrate to product. So here just the charge, bond energy, etc. becomes optimum so that it can now disintegrate to either substrate side or product side. So this is should not be confused with the reaction intermediates. So reaction intermediates like enzyme substrate complex and enzyme product complex are quite stable complexes. So how should we determine which one is stable? Because the reaction is very fast, all the steps go on in a very small time, like in nanoseconds or in the order of 10 to the power minus 12 seconds. So if a species created during a reaction is stable for more than 10 to the power minus 13 seconds, so that is the time taken by a molecular vibration, it can be called as a reaction intermediate. So our transition state is less stable than this, so that cannot be regarded as a reaction intermediate, but that is a fleeting state that is highly unstable, and it determines the formation of product from the substrate and vice versa. So a step in a reaction is the conversion of one intermediate to another intermediate. So the conversion of enzyme substrate to enzyme substrate complex is like step one, from enzyme substrate complex to enzyme product complex is step two, and from enzyme product complex to enzyme free enzyme and product is step 3. So there are 3 steps in this reaction. So out of these 3 steps, one step which has highest energy barrier is termed as the rate limiting step. So although there are many reactions which are multi-step, one of them will be the rate limiting step. And there are also reactions in which two comparable activation energy barriers are found. So those reactions are controlled by multiple steps. I mean, they have multiple rate limiting steps. So when the enzyme comes into play, it forms a optimal complex with the substrate, so that it not only decreases this energy barrier but also facilitate the dissociation of these complexes into the product side or from product side to the substrate side. So this determines the velocity of the reaction. So logically, when this energy is less, the heel is lower, the reaction is faster. So the rate of reaction is related to the energy heel by this equation. So the velocity V is equal to K into S. So K is kappa, which is the Greek letter K, into the molar concentration of the substrate. So this kappa is having this value. So here K is the Boltzmann constant. Constant, H is the Planck's constant, T is the absolute temperature, and we know these values. So this is the activation energy, and R is the universal gas constant, and T is again the absolute temperature. So here it may be noted that the velocity of the reaction is dependent on three important factors. So T is the absolute temperature. So if temperature is increased, the velocity of the reaction is going to increase. Then this activation energy. So as they are exponentially related, this velocity and activation energy, so lower this energy, more is the velocity. And this substrate, more is the substrate concentration, more is the velocity. So in the subsequent videos, we will see how this equation is derived.